If you don't know what Munchausen by animal proxy is, you as a veterinarian can't possibly diagnose it. You can't diagnose something you've never heard of. And there is still a real educational deficit. We as psychiatrists need to expand our reach and include veterinary programs. Right now, almost none, if not all, veterinary training programs have almost nothing or nothing about Munchausen by animal proxy.
I'm Carrie Hyde, the owner of the spa in Tustin, California, the first holistic, cage-free, relaxing spa for dogs, and this is the Spodcast. Why did I open the spa? Because during my time working with vets, I started to notice a pattern. Dogs and cats were getting sicker, and no one was asking why. So I had a decision to make. I left the veterinary field in 2000 and opened up the first holistic grooming salon in Orange County, California. Our philosophy at the spa is to advocate for the quality of your pet's overall health. And it is these reasons that we created this podcast, to open your eyes to the questions you may not even know to ask, and to talk with the experts that will shine light on the answers you need. This is a no-bull, tell-the-truth kind of podcast with the occasional pet pun. I'm Carrie Hyde, and I want to be your pet's life coach. You're listening to the Spodcast, produced by the Spa in Tustin, California. Make sure to subscribe wherever you get your podcast, and be sure to like and leave us a review of your thoughts on our show. And if you have a question about your furry family member, you can ask us by going to our Facebook page, The Spa in Tustin, California, because we want to be your pet's life coach. Enjoy the show! Hello and welcome to the Spodcast. My name is Carrie Hyde, and I'm your host, and I'm your pet's life coach. Today we're going to be talking about Munchausen's by proxy. Many of you have probably heard of this syndrome, and if you have, you're probably familiar with cases like Gypsy Rose, whose mother forced her into a wheelchair in order to gain sympathy as well as gain financial gain for her and her family. Gypsy Rose went on to begin to resent her mother, hate her mother, and eventually be involved in the murder of her mother. Other cases you might be familiar with is a case that happened back in the 70s and early 80s where a mother was able to kill 9 children under the premise that they were dying from SIDS, sudden infant death syndrome. But what many of you may not know is that Munchausen's by proxy affects animals. So many so that it has been shed light on by a lot of people. A lot of psychiatrists are now looking to help veterinarians and people who are running boarding facilities, grooming shops, and even for you who are living in neighborhoods and dogs that are out walking down the street could be victims of Munchausen's by proxy. So today I brought into our studio to talk about this, to try to figure out if there's something we can do to protect the innocent animals who do not have a voice, who cannot speak up and say that their caregivers are making them sick, injuring them, and, you know, ultimately if there's something we can do to identify it and to protect these innocent animals. So today I brought in the studio with me one of my clients who has a dog who I've actually talked about on the show before. You may have heard me talk about little Mama Bear. We talked about Mama Bear a while back. She has a little Chihuahua who I just adore, and I always talk about how Mama Bear is one of my favorite dogs that comes to the spa. She checks all the boxes. You know, like, I love all dogs, but some dogs check all of the boxes. Like, one of her boxes is, does she do tricks? And Mama Bear does so many tricks. Like, she's got all these tricks. She never barks. She never complains. She never does anything. I don't know what you know, her mom experiences at home, but she's the perfect dog.
No, she's pretty awesome.
She's a pretty awesome dog. So, Melanie, by the way, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
And thank you for being here. This is for you guys. This is Melanie Whitney. And she and I have a lot in common. So Melanie has done forensics before, speech and debate. She's now teaching at college communications and interpersonal communications. Mm-hmm. And this is going to be a hard topic for us to dive into. And so I needed someone to come in that could really help me understand how we can get to this debate that we need to do about how we're going to solve these problems. So I think I got the perfect person to do this. So Melanie, welcome to the show.
It sounds weird to say I'm happy to be here because it's such a kind of dark and tough topic. But I, like you said, having a comm studies background, I study humans, I study people, I study why we behave the way we do. And Dr. Feldman, I'm sure, is going to help us dive deeper to really be able to have these conversations and just common folks like me, just a pet parent, like how do we get involved in something like this? How can we advocate for these little souls, little furry babies that can't advocate for themselves? So let's get into it.
Yeah, we're going to dive into this. So of course, you know, I need to bring in some experts, especially, you know, most of the experts that I speak to are veterinarian experts and people in my field. But because this is a psychological problem that affects humans, I needed to bring in the expert on Munchausen. So I'd like to introduce you right now to Dr. Mark Feldman. Hi, Dr. Feldman. How are you?
Doing great. Thanks for having me.
Yes. Thank you so much for being here. Dr. Feldman is involved in psychiatry and psychology. He's a professor at the Alabama Tuscaloosa University, and he is an expert on Munchausen's by proxy. So Dr. Feldman, before we get super deep into this, let me back up a little bit. He has written hundreds of peer-reviewed articles on this, and it has written several books, including his most recent book that is out, which is called Dying to Be Ill. I highly recommend you get it. There's an entire chapter on animal abuse by people who have this condition. Which leads me to kind of my first question, Dr. Feldman. Is this Munchausen by proxy? Has the psychiatric community identified this as actually a psychiatric disorder, or is this something we're just considering it to be behavioral?
Well, I'll try not to use the whole hour to answer that question, but it's one of the most complex topics in all of psychiatry at this moment. Cut to the chase and just say the American Psychiatric Association does feel that this is a mental disorder. They started saying that in about, 2013. They call it by a really clunky and difficult term, factitious disorder imposed on another. And that another on whom illness is imposed can be a child, and is in most cases. It can be a dependent adult, an elderly person, or as we're going to discuss today, even a pet. But the behavior itself is still abuse, and we want to bear that in mind. It's possible to have a mental disorder and still be abusive, and that's the case when we're talking about Munchausen by proxy in pets.
I wanted to make sure we got that clarified, that we're talking about something that the psychiatric community does recognize as being that. You know, I know the story a little bit about why they call it Munchausen's by proxy, but can you tell us a little bit why they call it Munchausen's?
Yeah, this goes back centuries to a Baron Munchausen, who was a real person, who used to tell exaggerated stories about his military exploits. Someone wrote a book in England and had met the Baron and used his name on the book to apply to stories that were ridiculous on their face. But it nevertheless was a sensational book. It destroyed the Baron's reputation, and it has been in continuous publication ever since. And there are so many editions. I tried to buy all the editions I could find, and there are hundreds in all kinds of languages. So I didn't quite succeed in my effort there. But it was applied in 1951 to people who told fantastic stories about their medical conditions. And then in 1977, someone used the term to apply to people who lied about illness in their children, and it stuck. It's kind of an entertaining story. It's interesting. And so people to this day know about it, not as factitious disorder imposed on another, but as Munchausen by proxy or related conditions.
So this is much different, though. When we're talking about Munchausen's by proxy or Munchausen's without the by proxy on it, is much different than being a hypochondriac, right? Like, this isn't someone who's thinks they're ill.
Overly cautious about everything, yeah.
Right. Well, there's a clear difference between the two of them, right?
There is, and you're way ahead of most psychiatrists who don't know that, even despite all
you
their
guys hear
training.
That? I'm way ahead, way ahead, way ahead.
The psychiatrists sometimes miss the subtlety that a person with hypochondria honestly believes that they're ill. They tend to be oversensitive to minor physical sensations, the aches and pains we all get from time to time, but they're not intending to deceive anyone else. Whereas the person with Munchausen syndrome, whether they make themselves sick or a pet or child sick, knows that they're not, that the child is not ill, but lies to others about it or actually induces an illness deliberately so that they can say, look at this sick child I've been burdened with.
Wow. So I have a question then. So I have some background in sexual assault and sexual abuse work. And when we talk about predators, they have something we call power arousal. So there's a clear drive of dominance and power over another person who is vulnerable. So when we're talking about this disorder, is there something that is driving them? Is there something, like I would say with about a sexual predator, they are seeking dominance over another. Is there something like this here when we're talking about they know this animal is not sick, but they are making them sick? Am I making sense? Is my question making sense? Is there something driving them?
I often talk about the issue of control, which is the word I've tended to use. People who may feel like they have little control in their personal lives can feel once again in control by manipulating the health of another person or pet. The main reason why most of the perpetrators do what they do is because they're looking for attention and sympathy and care and concern that they feel unable to get in any other way. And that often stems from their having severe personality disorders. And that just means that they have long-term maladaptive, potentially self-destructive even, ways of getting their needs met. But others intend their behavior to be an expression of their feeling out of control, or they're feeling rageful toward a pet who or person whom they feel undermines their life in some way, requires too much attention, and robs them of the attention they're seeking. So by making a child or pet sick, they become known as the indefatigable caregiver of a pet who's very sick, and they achieve both control and attention and sympathy as a result.
Wow.
So are there different ways that they go about it? Does it graduate? Like, does somebody start off with little things and then will it increase? Do they always start out with killing or attempting to kill, like we see with the woman who killed all of those 9 children? Was that the suffocate them, or did she start off by slowly making them sick and work up to that? Will it get worse if it's not treated?
Well, you know, there are 3 basic mechanisms by which Munchausen by proxy perpetrators act, and one is to feign or falsely report illness. So it's the mildest form. They simply take a pet to the vet and say he's not eating, but they haven't actually done anything to make the pet sick. The others exaggerate. So the pet might have a minor disorder, but they wildly exaggerate it to the vet to get treatment. And then there are those who actively induce illness in the pet. They may inject the pet with bacteria to cause a raging infection or do other things like that. And it is true that some, but not all, perpetrators move from the milder end of the spectrum to the more severe induction end of the spectrum. And that happens with children too. Mm-hmm. If they're not getting their needs met by simply falsely reporting symptoms, they often quickly escalate and start making the pet sick.
Wow.
But death is not usually what they're after because that removes the object that they're manipulating. And I'm referring to the pet as an object because that's how they view the pet. Not as a living creature to be loved, but as an object to be manipulated.
Oh my gosh, that makes perfect sense.
So I don't know if there's an answer to this question, but is this something that someone who is completely healthy-minded, quote-unquote normal person, could experience some type of trauma and then start doing this to their pet? Or is this like a neuro thing where you are, there's something wrong with these people who do these things? Or is there kind of like people who hoard or who have OCD? Sometimes there's a trauma that triggers this.
Well, that's the point. There's been very little research into Munchausen by animal proxy. I published the first case report back in 1997.